Okay, let's take a look at this this work here. All right, well, the first one is a volume and surface area. So take a look and listen. First of all, volume of anything is big B times H. And since it doesn't come to a point, you do not divide by 3. The bottom is a circle. Now, you should know that that is pi radius squared for the area times the height, which is 10. So it's 3.14 times the radius squared times 10. So the radius is 8, so it's 8 times 8. So the volume is really easy. Now remember, volume is going to be cubic. So on this one right here, what you're going to do is actually work this out. So you're going to clear your calculator out. That's 64 times 10 is 640. So it's 640 times 3.14, and I get 2009.6 cubic inches. It's volume. All right, that was pretty easy. Now I want you to compare that to surface area, so listen carefully. Surface area, and there's no formula that I'm giving you, okay, so you just need to know it. It's the top and bottom, so it's two circles, okay? It's the surface. It's everywhere you can touch. So it's two circles, okay, two circles plus the rectangular cylinder that forms the body of this thing. Like if you roll this up, it turns into a cylinder. Okay, so if you roll it up, it turns into a cylinder. Anyway, so the circles are 2 times pi radius squared. That's easy. So it's two of those plus this part right here is the part that actually wraps around the circle. So that would be your circumference. So it's going to be the circumference of the circle, okay, plus the height, which is 10. So it's circumference times the height. So it's 2 times 3.14 times the radius squared. The radius, 8 times 8, and circumference is pi times diameter. Okay, so this is going to be 3.14 times the diameter. The diameter is 16, so times 16 times 10 plus all of this stuff here. So it's two circles plus circumference times the height. And they're not going to give you that formula, so you just need to know it's two circles, and then circumference is that top part which wraps around the circle times the height of the cylinder. So it's going to be 64 times 3.14 equals, and then times 2 equals. All right, so this first number here, and you can check, double check my math, I get that. Okay, this one right here is going to be 160 times 3.14. So 160 times 3.14, and I get 502.4. So I'm going to add that up, plus 401.92. Remember, you must have your calculators out to avoid demerits and to avoid losing points. So it's 904.32. And this is surface area, so this is going to be square inches. Remember, anything with area is square inches. And let me just go over this visually with you, okay? So just give me a moment. And let me cut a little rectangle to make the cylinder. All right, so what you have here visually is this. Here's your rectangle. It's kind of hard to see white on white, so I'm going to outline it with this. Okay, so here's your rectangle. If you take your rectangle and you roll it like this, okay, and if you roll it into a cylinder and then seam it up with something, glue or solder or weld or whatever. So if you solder it or weld it, you have your cylinder, and there's your top circle and there's your bottom circle. And this part right here, the circumference of the circle, is actually the top edge of this rectangle. And that's what I was trying to show you in this diagram. This top edge actually wraps around the circle. All right, in any event, hopefully you understand that it's circumference times the height is your lateral area. So sometimes they ask you for lateral area, and now that I'm thinking about it, put LA here. So your lateral area is the sides. All right, hopefully you understood that. Let's go on. This right here says it's a parallelogram. Just by that diagram. Okay, remember there's five properties. One of them is opposite angles are equal. So 2x plus 4 is equal to 80. And you got to know to write that. Now go ahead and work that out. So we're going to subtract 4 and then divide by 2. So when you subtract 4, you get 76 divided by 2, whatever that is. I think it's 38. And so x is equal to 38. You can plug it back in and see if you get 80. All right, on the next one right here, notice that this line is parallel to that line. Therefore, alternating exteriors are equal. So you're going to do 2x minus 5 is equal to 100. And then you got to work that out. So go ahead. You're going to add 5 and get 105, and then you're going to divide by 2. It's not going to be pretty. It's going to be a decimal. So take 105 divided by 2, and what you get is 52.5. So x is 52.5. Now I want y as well. Now top, these are corresponding, so they're equal. So all you got to do is plug in 52.5 into this. So 2 times, or you can just do vertical angles. It's got to be 100. All right, so that's easy. So that's got to be 100 because they're vertical. But you could plug it in as well, top. All right, I think that wraps up the bell work. Let's go on to something different here. Let's go to properties of kites and trapezoids. So draw that diagram, or rather copy all of that down. Okay? Now once you copy it down, there's something called a mid-segment theorem. And first we've got to talk about what a trapezoid is. Now I have some notes here. So let me just go over some things with you, okay? All right, let me find the trapezoids first. First of all, you got to know what a trapezoid is, okay? Well, a trapezoid is a quadrilateral. And let me show you the big picture, too. I got it somewhere up in here. Just give me a second to find it. All right, so before we do anything else, draw all of these, or draw this diagram here. Let me minimize it so you can see it. Okay, so draw this diagram here. Okay? And stop moving. So it might have stopped recording. Oh. Okay, let's practice.